Hey, this is Mad Hatter, and this is going to be a showcase of an item sorter that I put together. It's not going to be a block-for-block tutorial, because that would take ages, and I think I have some more work to do on optimizing, but I wanted to show you, because I think this is 80% the way there, maybe 90% the way there. So this is a minecart item categorizer, and it gets weird sort rates. It's not like the traditional item sorters where the sort rate is always the same. This one will sort somewhere between 3.5 hopper speed or 8.8 items per second down to, well, one item per second. It just depends upon what your input is. So in a normal case, like just a normal mixed shulker, it's about 2.5 hopper speed. Or about 6 items per second. So that's pretty quick as item sorters go. And let me show you how this works. So let's grab a barrel. We're just gonna break that barrel and dump all of these items in. I'm gonna leave the barrel with the data in it in my inventory just because reasons. Well, actually, I'm gonna just toss it off the edge here. And you can see the items are just flying out. It's the beauty of hopper minecarts. Now, as we're going, the items will be coming into these chests and they'll be sorted into categories. The first category is going to be wood bits. The second, and it's going to take up these two rows of chests. The second category is going to be stone bits. This is going to be logs and saplings. This is going to be overflow. This is going to be empty. This is going to be redstone bits. And this is going to be deep slate bits. And if we give it some time, it'll actually sort them all out, but let's go jump up and show you what's actually going on. We're gonna start at the top. By the way, that's the machine. It's absolutely massive. So at the top, you can see we have this squiggly rail and minecarts are wiggling back and forth and then they get kicked out to the left and to the right. When they get kicked out, they run over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hoppers. Each one of those hoppers pulls one item out, and then they fall into that powdered snow down there, and they get explodificated into items. So now the way that this is working is the minecart comes up and it tries to grab an item out of this barrel. If it can grab an item, these observers fire and the rail flip-flops whichever way it needs to go. So in these minecarts, you can see we have 4 shovels and then a stack of items. And when it pulls an item out of this barrel, it gets routed this way. And the first shovel, second shovel, third shovel, and fourth shovel go here. And then the item it pulls out goes here and gets returned back into the barrel. You can see that the rail ticks over when the minecart goes underneath the barrel, and then once again when the minecart goes back over and puts its item back in. So that's really how the sorter works, is it does that. The next thing that happens is these minecarts get explodificated, and we need to separate the minecart from the items. This minecart breaker I learned on the Advanced Automation Discord from Tartar. Tartar gave me the design for this, and the way it works is this curved rail forces the minecart to intersect with the lava, and then the items pop off and go that way. It is extremely directional, and this entire build is extremely directional, so that's going to be fine for our needs. Next thing that happens is it goes into a non-stackable item sorter. What this is going to do is it's going to put all the items in this chest, and it's going to separate the minecarts or stackable items, it doesn't really know the difference, from the normal stackable items. The minecarts will go down into this chest, down again, and then into this auto dropper or auto dispenser, and the auto dispenser will send them straight into there. Right now, I do not have protection for shulkers, and I don't have protection for normal minecarts. Both of those will break this setup, so I am not quite really ready to do a block for block until I figure out how I'm going to separate out shulkers and how I'm going to separate out potential problems in this minecart separator. And by the way, that's not hard. It's just something that it's got to get done, and I haven't done it yet. What we've gone over so far is the minecart separators, the non-stackable item filters, and we've seen in here is the items. And if we look, it's already done sorting. I haven't probably cut too much of the time out of this video. I will have cut a little bit of pause dead time, but it's not going to be many minutes. So that's how long it took to sort a shulker. Let's put another shulker of stuff in here and we'll keep going. And we'll toss that off into the void. So now this light is how we know that these timer circuits are still running. This is all based off of timing, because if I base it off of signal strength, some weird things happen when you get stackables, non-stackables, and it is less reliable. So this is all based upon timing. The way that that timing starts is we get items that show up in this hopper minecart. This is on a detector rail, and as items show up in here, it triggers three different circuits here on this red line. The first circuit is it kicks off this timer circuit. We'll go over the timer circuit later, but this is sending a pulse to start the timer. The second circuit is the off circuit. It'll lock this piece of redstone dust when we're out of items, and it'll cause the machine to safely shut down. This is a pulse that occurs when the timer runs out, and it goes over to the restart circuit. The third circuit that it runs off of this red start timer circuit is this accelerator to bump start the sorting process. This white circuit really isn't needed, but it speeds up the starting of your sorter by about 3 seconds or so. So I added it in so that we could have the fastest start time. This circuit here, when timer goes off, it pulses the timer back on. This blue line is just running to a 4-tick repeater, which allows this comparator decay circuit to work correctly. This comparator decay circuit is just timed to be able to allow 42 items to go in there. Why 42? Because it's a number less than 64 but greater than 32, and it's what I happen to get going with this circuit. It's a good number, and we'll stick with that number. This cyan circuit fires when the redstone burns out, and it triggers these two pistons to move over. The first piston's got a fence on it that allows the minecart to leave. The second piston has this observer on it, which fires the next minecart. Now, to make sure that we don't leave a minecart down there, because that can cause some really interesting problems, we actually grab a fourth signal out of this comparator. This comparator is doing work. It has four different things it does. That comparator powers this black block, which turns off the start pulse, or the release of minecart pulse. It just leaves the observer extended, so that way we don't have an observer sitting here when we're not actually sorting. Like I said, that is just because we can get some really strange things that happen if the minecart is sitting there right when we put items in. So that is the redstone down there. I've kind of walked through it. There are signs here to kind of explain what all these mean. I may put this out in a world download, but I'm not sure. I don't really like to do world downloads. We'll see what happens. If there is a world download, it'll be in the Discord. It's not going to be just click through the video. You will have to actually watch the video to this point to actually know that there's a world download. That is basically the entire redstone to drive this. There's a couple of other things that we have on the backside. First is the shovel sorter. We don't want to end up with any stackable items in here. Well, in the time that it took us to record this video so far, we've done two shulkers. So let's get a third one going. Okay, let it run. Now, we don't want to ever have a stackable item in here. I don't care if they're not shovels. They could be... You could make this netherite armor. I don't care, but it has to be non-stackable. And I'm using wood shovels because they're easy to craft and they're non-stackable. If you have a better item, let me know in the comments, but it has to be non-stackable. Now, we have a non-stackable item filter up here to separate the stackables from the non-stackables. And that is it's just a simple non-stackable item sorter. Then the other portion we have is the minecarts coming down. Now the minecarts are an interesting thing. If we were to actually use this as a main storage, I think a main storage should be able to take a random mix of items, which is what we've been testing with so far, but it should also be able to take an entire shulker of items and just empty those. I don't recommend putting hoppers into here. I recommend doing it by hand where you just transfer all the items in by hand. But the shulker, like this thing completely full of wood, should not break the system. And in order to make that true, you have to fill up exactly this one double chest of hopper minecarts, this hopper, and this dispenser. If you put more than that in, what will happen is it would overwhelm the two hopper speed item dump, and it would eventually cause items to sit up in this corner and despawn. Now, that's not a huge problem generally, but the real problem is the minecarts will despawn and eventually you'll end up down to having just this anyway. So I highly recommend keeping exactly a double chest of minecarts down there or less, but no more than a double chest of minecarts. And then if you do put a double chest of minecarts here, you want to have four double chests of your non-stackable items, because the way that it works out is there's always going to be four shovels in here. So if you put four times as many non-stackable items, then you do minecarts, you're never going to have them run out. However, if you only put like, let's say, a double chest here and a double chest there, there is a chance that you could run out of shovels. And if you run out of shovels, this can break. Basically, you would have two items here that it could be inserted, and if both items do get inserted, it'll pull through whichever one comes first here, and then it will go into that channel and it'll mix up your items. So you never want that to happen, because it'll also mix up this barrel. Okay, last thing that we need to cover, and that'll be once the sorter stops, which is going to be pretty soon. Yeah, it's very soon, actually. Two more minecarts. One, two, and now this is going to all shut down and the light goes off. Now, you never want to do this while the machine is running, but here is how you actually program the item sorters. First, you put whatever you want in these barrels. Whatever's in this barrel here will end up going down this hole. Whatever's in this barrel here will end up going down this hole. Whatever's in this barrel here goes down that hole. And then anything that is not in any of the barrels goes down this hole. One thing that you're going to want while actually programming this is leather boots. If you fall in that hole, it sucks. You can't really get out. With leather boots, you can walk over, even in survival. You can walk over this powdered snow, no problem. If you don't have leather boots on, it'll be a bad day. On this side, because of the way that it works out, you need to actually reach in beside the barrel. You can see what's in each of these chests that way. So when an item comes through here, it ends up getting pulled out and the minecart goes up and around like we discussed before. So only the items in here go into this hole. Anyway, that is what I have for you today. While I've been actually building this, I've been playing with some mini games. I'm thinking that I might want to build this on Skyblock because I can, and that might take me a little bit of time to get the kinks worked out fully. But if I do build this on Skyblock, you'll see that in an episode. Anyway, I'm going to be a little bit behind on Skyblock because I actually want to do tutorials on those, what I'm calling micro games. So I have a micro game of shuttleboard. I have a micro game of a roulette style game, and I have a micro game of Plinko that I want to do tutorials on. So Skyblock's going to slow down just a little bit, but now that I have Redstone on those worlds, I'm motivated to go play with Redstone again. So this is Hatter, and I'm out. Bye.